Hey everybody, my name is Michelangelo, engineering lead on the Knowledge Graph. Modern software development is built on complexity. Codebases are larger and more interconnected than ever before. How can you confidently refactor a method in a massive codebase without knowing what it'll affect? How does a new team member get up to speed on a decade-old project with thousands of dependencies? Answering these questions require more than just reading code. It requires understanding its structure and all of its hidden dependencies. This challenge isn't just for humans. It's the single biggest roadblock for AI coding agents. Our current AI tools often lack a deep, structural, and most importantly, semantic understanding of our code. Agents of today rely on basic techniques like code chunking, embeddings, grep, and keyword searches. While typical agents can handle medium-sized repositories with these tools, the ability of an agent to efficiently fit the correct data into its context window degrades as the codebase size scales. To solve this, we need to give both developers and AI the ability to retrieve the best context for enterprise-grade projects without needing to rely on LSPs, expensive runtime analysis, or complex tooling. As a first step, we decided to build the GitLab Knowledge Graph. Before we start, let's talk about what the GitLab Knowledge Graph is. The Knowledge Graph is a framework written in Rust to turn your codebase and SDLC into a live, embeddable graph database to give agents maximal AI context quality. With this first iteration, you can parse multiple languages into a single call graph, connect via MCP, and query your entire workspace in less than 100 milliseconds. Future iterations will build on this to incorporate full SDLC data connected to the graph. We started with a code index that can work directly in your IDE or CLI agents as the foundation. In future iterations, we will deliver the Knowledge Graph as a service that enables you to query your code across GitLab. So let's check it out. The initial code graph is designed to be installed as a binary and run on your machine in your IDE. It supports Mac, Windows, and Linux. We can start up the server with a simple one-line installation. Once installed, the Knowledge Graph has first-class integration directly in your IDE with the GitLab VS Code extension. The extension automatically manages the Knowledge Graph daemon service, a light 10 megabyte background process that powers all real-time indexing and querying. With the service running, you can launch the Knowledge Graph Explorer. This Explorer is your central hub for managing and exploring the graph. By default, the Knowledge Graph discovers all the repositories in your workspace and creates separate queryable call graphs for each project. The indexing process is built with performance in mind for massive enterprise codebases. Here, we're indexing over 50,000 files in the GitLab monolith in under 10 seconds. Once your project is indexed, you can dive in and explore its structure. The Explorer provides a complete interactive visualization of your code's graph. From there, you can search all the various relationships inside your graph. You can see the methods a class contains and how your code connects together. Later, you'll be able to leverage this Explorer for writing your own custom queries and architectural visualizations. The goal is not just to visualize this data, though. It's to give our AI agents direct access to this new context. To start, we've built several baseline tools for your agent to interact with the graph. Like we mentioned before, we now have a multi-language call graph that gives IDE-like powers to coding agents. Before we show you the agent interacting with the graph, it's important to understand some of the core functionality we've built. Let's walk through some of the tools we've created that you can plug into your agents with MCP. Now that we're in the MCP inspector with the Knowledge Graph running, let's start with the Get References tool. This tool lets the agent discover who calls this with real call sites. Let's use this Java user service sample app as an example. We have a model class for interacting with the database, and we want to see all the places the getUsername method is called to assess what needs to be updated if we refactor this method. In the graph here, we can see that the getUsername method is used by the user service and the user controller, but we can also see that it's indirectly used by other classes. With the references tool, you can see that we're able to get concrete references to the getUsername method with the locations and a full call stack, not just basic string matches like you would get in grep. We can also let the model get the exact source code for a call statement in your code. Here's an example where the model can just jump into a call site, just like a human engineer would. Similar to get definition, we have two other tools for grabbing semantically accurate information from the codebase at scale. We can quickly search the user service and user control classes with the search codebase definitions tool, and then we can let the agent extract both of these classes with the redefinition tool. A key point to mention here that applies to all tools we show is that each code block returned is the correct definition according to the AST, meaning that the agent will not miss important code chunks as opposed to grep. Now going back to our get username example, here's a side-by-side of when we ask the agent the impact of refactoring that method. On the left, we have an agent with basic grep tools and file reads. On the right, the agent only has access to the knowledge graph. You can see that in only 3 tool calls, we are able to extract roughly the same information as the basic agent. Now let's scale up some of the example projects we're using and show some of the tools that are built for large codebases. Let's start with the GitLab monolith, which is a large Ruby on Rails codebase. Here's the GitLab monolith loaded into our knowledge graph. Similar to humans, LLMs have a finite amount of information allowed into its context window. This means you can't dump a 50,000 file codebase into an LLM. We can combat this, though, by giving coding agents an API map of your files ranked by usage. This is where the repo map tool comes into play. Let's say I'm new to the codebase and I'm tasked with adding a new controller to the admin page for a knowledge graph admin settings panel. I want to examine all of the admin controllers for GitLab. If we were to include all the files under this folder alone, we'd occupy 80% of the typical context window. With the repo map tool, as shown here, the agent can use an API map of your codebase to traverse thousands of files effectively. Lastly, let's show the import usage tool. The import usage tool conducts dependency analysis on the graph to resolve imports throughout a codebase. Here are 2 projects well known in the AI community, FastAPI and PyTorch. Here's an example with FastAPI where we look up a package across 4,000 files. And here's another example where we look up a dependency usage in the PyTorch repo. Now, let's check out how an agent will actually interact with this tool. In the example, we have the popular Spring Boot framework loaded into our knowledge graph. This framework has over 10,000 Java files. Let's imagine we have another Log4j 0-day vulnerability. We've asked the agent to find usages of the dependency, and more importantly, find the associated code that could be affected. On the left, we have the agent with over 15 tool calls and a basic analysis of affected components. On the right, though, we have our knowledge graph agent, which uses just 8 tool calls. More importantly, it identified all the downstream dependencies affected by the exploit, which the basic agent might have missed. These are just some of the basic capabilities we're starting with. We plan on adding custom query ability and agent-enabled graph traversal ability in the future. To validate the knowledge graph's impact on RAG performance, we tested it against the Software Engineering BenchLite benchmark, one of the most popular and widely accepted benchmarks available for testing code agents. We put a twist on the benchmark, though, and intentionally made it more difficult. Our agents had no shell access where they could execute code, no access to LSP hints like other agentic IDEs, no embedding search capabilities, and just a 6-minute time limit to solve real-world bugs from open-source packages with millions of users. Consistently, the knowledge graph outperformed common tools like grep and glob and even task and to-do tools, jumping from a 21% baseline to over 30% while taking significantly less time to resolve the average issue. We are very excited to continue iterating on our tools, hearing feedback from early adopters, and of course, continuing to thoroughly evaluate GKG against both larger datasets and larger codebases. Now, let's take a glimpse into some of the future capabilities of the knowledge graph. We want this to be a framework that developers can use to extend their own knowledge graph. Let's use Next.js as an example. Next.js API configuration is difficult to track down because you have to do it through exposing constants in your route.ts files. With a config file as shown here, we can specify the exact AST nodes we'd like to match and tie them to existing nodes in the graph. After indexing, we can see our custom nodes in our graph. But more importantly, this extensibility will allow developers to query all of their Next.js get routes with a single config and query, as shown in this custom tool here. When we give this power to agents, we can ask agents questions like, what routes use the webhook utils package with confidence? And notice here how we identified all 5 routes out of the 200 routes throughout this project in a single tool call. And to reiterate, this is just the start. Our vision is to connect the code indexing to items across the SDLC to bring a unified data layer that your agents can access. We'll also unlock cross-project graph search. With that in place, you can imagine how with the Log4j example we showed before, you will be able to identify usage sites of an affected dependency across your entire organization. Here's an example of the Log4j report tied to the knowledge graph inside my local GitLab instance. Now we can ask the agent broad questions like, find all of the Log4j vulnerabilities and exactly where they're used in the GitLab org. Rather than just getting reports themselves, we can get the reports in all of the Log4j usages with their exact lines in just a few queries. And for some orgs, this impact compounds as they scale to thousands of projects and microservices. As we index relationships from the SDLC data like issues, merge requests, and CI, as shown here, we will also enable powerful downstream agents like the Deep Research Agent, which allows you to ask questions that can summarize every related work item, issue, security scan, merge requests, and other items all the way down to a single line of code. So that's it for today. I would like to thank the team who worked very hard to make this public beta a reality. You can download and try the Knowledge Graph today. Thanks for watching.